Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Genetic Basis of Inheritance. In that we are studying topic Incomplete Dominance. Now when I say incomplete dominance, it is also called as Non-Mendelian Inheritance. Why it is called Non-Mendelian Inheritance? Let's study and find out the answer to it. Incomplete dominance. Now according to Mendel's law, there was codominance, there was dominance, law of independent assortment, which stated certain laws which were clear and easy. Now there is certain thing which is called as incomplete dominance. The definition for incomplete dominance goes that if there is a dominant allele present or a pair of genes present which is completely dominant. Now this completely dominant genes or pair of allele will not hide or mask its recessive counterpart or its recessive partners, and it will allow the expression only a little bit in its recessive counterparts. Let me give you all a simple example. For example, if someone crosses a red rose with a pink rose, or you can say a simple language, red rose is crossed with a white rose. Now, red color is dominant, while the white color is recessive. So according to Mendel's law, we always say that the dominant one will overpower the recessive one and the dominant one will be the color. But we do observe light pink color in roses. We all have seen that. Now that is an example of incomplete dominance. In incomplete dominance, what we observe is the alleles of red rose never try to mask the alleles of the white rose, or you can say the red parent never try to hide the white parent gametes or alleles, and this results into another form of parent, or you can say another form of hybrid, which is the pink hybrid, which is just the combination of both of them. Now it was called as Non-Mendelian Inheritance because when Mendel laid down all these laws, he was very clear about certain things like homozygosity, heterozygosity, dominant alleles, recessive alleles, hybrids, which clearly does not follow this pattern of incomplete dominance, which was little different from Mendel's point of view. Now Mendel stated very clearly that the dominant one or the stronger one will always appear in a generation phenotypically, but this does not happen over here. What we observe is that the dominant one allow the recessive one just to show its character, even if it's little bit. Incomplete dominance. Now the law of dominance clearly states that the strong one, or you can say whether it is homozygous strong or whether it is heterozygous strong, dominant allele will always be expressed. Now this is just a flip to the law of dominance, which is incomplete dominance, which in simple language states that the dominant one will be seen in any generation, but it will not kill, or you can say it will not suppress or hide its recessive counterpart. Law of incomplete dominance clearly states that when a dominant allele or a gene or a form of a gene does not completely mask or hide the effect of the recessive partner or recessive allele, and the organism resulting shows a physical appearance or a blending of both the alleles, pink rose, as I've told you all up. Now in roses, we all have seen the red variety of rose and the white variety of rose. Always the red variety is the dominant or the strongest one, whether it is homozygous dominant or heterozygous dominant. Whereas the white variety, whether it is in homozygous condition or in heterozygous condition, is always recessive or the weak partner. So that heterozygous roses are formed after the mixing of the red rose and the white rose, which were pink in color. The basic experiment which Correns did, one of the disciplines of Gregor Mendel, was he basically crossed a red flower strain or a red flower with a white flower strain. Now red was dominant, that everybody knew, and white was the recessive. But what he observed was the law of incomplete dominance, the law of partially allowing another partner to grow or to proceed its quality. The F1 hybrids were pink in color, and this pink in color is an intermediate color. When I say intermediate, it means somewhere in the middle. It is neither reddish nor whitish in color. Now the law of incomplete dominance not only governs Mendel's pea plant, it also governs different human beings in the terms of your eye color, in the terms of your hair color. Your parents would have certain colors of eyes, for example black, and other parent would have certain color of eye. Now you could have a combination of both or just little different. Hair color, or you can say your skin color, sometimes show incomplete dominance. In flowers, any intermediate color flower is a result of incomplete dominance, and this incomplete dominance serves as a process of serving better variety in floriculture or just producing better hybrid varieties. Students, in this part of the chapter, what did we study was about non-Mendelian inheritance, or in simple language you can say the law of incomplete dominance. I hope y'all are clear about this law. Thank you.